Jason slammed his fist on the podium, his voice booming through the vast council chamber. If you spineless bureaucrats fail to stop the Andromedan atrocities, humanity will unleash the full force of our military might. The blood will be on your hands. The alien council members shifted uneasily on their floating platforms, multiple eyes blinking and twitching appendages, betraying their apprehension. They had convened to address the Andromedan Empire's incursions into human space. Disturbing reports of forced labor and resource plundering on colony worlds demanded action. Ambassador Jason Johnson, a tall human with broad shoulders and a granite jaw, had presented damning video evidence of Andromedan brutality. Human families ripped apart, children crying for missing parents, colonists toiling under the guns of insectoid overseers. Yet the council hesitated to intervene against the fearsome Andromedans, cowering from the prospect of total war. Vortis, the Andromedan ruler, chittered a dismissal of the footage as fabricated propaganda. Seething with cold rage, Jason issued humanity's ultimatum: act now to protect human lives, or face the consequences of mankind's wrath. The threat hung in the air, suffocating, impossible to ignore. Frenzied murmurs erupted through the chamber. Panicked eyes darted. Tentacles twitched. The galaxy teetered on a razor's edge between a fragile status quo and a future consumed by the fires of war. The council had to decide. Humanity's fate, and perhaps the fate of galactic civilization itself, would depend on their next move. Failure to act would carry a price in blood. The council chamber erupted into a cacophony of agitated voices and clicking mandibles as the members called for an immediate recess. Jason stood rigid at the podium, his eyes locked on the scattering representatives, daring them to ignore humanity's plight. A webbed hand tapped Jason's arm, drawing his attention to a diminutive amphibious creature. Xyloth, the Aquarian representative, blinked up at him with bulbous eyes filled with empathy. "Ambassador Johnson, a word in private?" Xyloth's voice gurgled through his translators. Jason nodded curtly and followed Xyloth to a secluded alcove. The Aquarian glanced around furtively before speaking. "You have the Aquarian's support. We too have suffered under the Andromedans' cruelty. They drained our oceans, leaving our people to suffocate on the shores." Xyloth's gills flared with anger. "An alliance between our species could tip the scales against Vortis." Jason raised an eyebrow, intrigued by the proposal. "I'm listening. Let's discuss this further in a secure location." In the heart of the Andromedan sector, Vortis slammed his clawed fists against the obsidian walls of his throne room. The human's insolence burned like acid in his gut. "Summon the War Council," Vortis screeched, mandibles clicking furiously. "We accelerate our plans. The human colonies will be crushed beneath our might." His commanders scurried to obey, their compound eyes glinting with malice. Vortis turned to his spymaster, a spindly creature draped in shadows. "To infiltrate Earth, uncover their weaknesses. We must be prepared for war." On the blue planet, news feeds buzzed with Jason's ultimatum. In the streets, opinions clashed like thunderclouds. Some lauded him as a champion of humanity, while others cowered in fear of Andromedan retribution. Deep beneath the Earth Defense Council's headquarters, generals huddled around holographic displays of secret weapons long hidden from public view. Sleek warships pulsing with advanced technology, exoskeletons that turned soldiers into walking tanks, the full might of human ingenuity ready to be unleashed. Jason's comm device chirped with an encrypted message, coordinates to a distant, uninhabited world, a promise of truth about the Andromedans. The risk was high, but the potential reward even higher. He assembled a team of humanity's finest warriors, their faces etched with grim determination. Together, they boarded a stealth ship and set course for the unknown, ready to uncover the secrets that could change everything. As the stars streaked past the viewport, Jason clenched his jaw, knowing that the fate of his species hung in the balance. The path ahead was shrouded in uncertainty, but one thing was clear: humanity would not go quietly into the night. Jason's stealth ship touched down on the desolate planet's surface, Kicking up a cloud of dust and debris, the team disembarked, weapons at the ready, scanning the barren landscape for any signs of life. The thin atmosphere made breathing a challenge, forcing them to rely on their suit's oxygen supply. As they approached the rendezvous point, a sense of unease settled over the group. The eerie silence was broken by the sudden crack of gunfire. Andromedan soldiers, their exoskeletons glinting in the dim light, emerged from concealed positions, unleashing a hail of plasma bolts. "Ambush!" Jason yelled, diving for cover behind a nearby boulder. His team scrambled to find shelter, returning fire with their pulse rifles. The air sizzled with the exchange of deadly energy beams. The Andromedans pressed their attack, attempting to flank the humans. Jason popped up from behind his cover, taking aim at an advancing soldier. His shot found its mark, burning through the insectoid's chitinous armor. Despite their efforts, the team found themselves outgunned and outnumbered. The Andromedans closed in, their mandibles clicking with anticipation of an easy victory. Just as all seemed lost, a brilliant flash of light erupted from a hidden cave entrance. A figure emerged, wielding a weapon unlike anything Jason had ever seen. It pulsed with an eerie green glow, emitting a high-pitched whine as it charged up. The mysterious savior aimed the weapon at the Andromedan forces and fired. A wave of energy swept across the battlefield, causing the soldiers to convulse and collapse, their exoskeletons crumbling to dust. As the dust settled, the figure approached Jason and his team, lowering his hood to reveal a scarred and weathered Andromedan face. "I am Zorax," he said, his voice tinged with a metallic echo. "We have much to discuss." Inside the cave, Zorax shared his incredible tale. He had been a scientist working on the Andromedans' secret genetic engineering projects when he stumbled upon the truth about his species' origin. "We are not a natural evolution," Zorax explained, his compound eyes reflecting the dim light. "The Andromedans were created by an ancient alien race, long extinct, as the ultimate warriors. But the experiment went wrong. We became uncontrollable, driven by an insatiable hunger for conquest and destruction." Jason listened intently, his mind reeling from the revelation. Zorax continued, revealing an even more disturbing truth. "Vortis is merely a puppet, controlled by a hidden council of genetically enhanced Andromedans, known as the Overmind. They possess powerful psychic abilities and have been manipulating the Galactic Council for centuries, ensuring that no one stands in the way of their expansionist agenda." Armed with this knowledge, Jason realized the true scope of the threat facing the galaxy. He immediately contacted the Earth Defense Council and Aquarian leadership, urging them to mobilize for total war against the Andromedans. In a secure transmission to the Galactic Council, Jason laid bare the truth about the Andromedan threat, imploring the undecided members to join the fight. The revelation sent shockwaves through the Council, galvanizing them into action. As the various factions prepared for the coming conflict, Jason and Zorax began formulating a plan to strike at the heart of the Andromedan power structure. They would need to assemble a team of the galaxy's most skilled warriors and infiltrate the Overmind's stronghold. Jason looked at Zorax, a newfound respect and determination in his eyes. "We'll need the best of the best for this mission. Let's get to work." Together, they set out to gather their team, each member bringing unique abilities and a shared resolve to end the Andromedan menace once and for all. The fate of the galaxy hung in the balance, and failure was not an option. Jason's heart pounded as he and Zorax's team infiltrated the Overmind stronghold, their Aquarian stealth suits rendering them nearly invisible. They crept through the winding corridors, avoiding patrols and disabling security systems with surgical precision. The air grew thick with tension as they delved deeper into the heart of the enemy's lair. Suddenly, a blast of energy seared the wall beside Jason's head. Vortis emerged from the shadows, his exoskeleton crackling with power. "Did you really think you could sneak in here undetected?" he hissed, mandibles clicking with malice. Jason and his team opened fire, but Vortis moved with unnatural speed, dodging their shots and closing the distance. He lashed out with razor-sharp claws, sending sparks flying as they clashed against Jason's armor. Zorax leaped into the fray, his own genetically enhanced strength a match for Vortis. They traded blows in a deadly dance, the corridor echoing with the sounds of their battle. Just as Jason lined up a clear shot, Vortis unleashed a devastating energy blast. Time seemed to slow as Zorax threw himself in front of Jason, absorbing the brunt of the attack. The Andromedan scientist crumpled to the ground, his body smoking and broken. Jason rushed to Zorax's side, cradling his fallen comrade. Zorax pressed a data crystal into Jason's hand, his voice a fading whisper. "The Overmind's weakness, a secret weapon. Use it. End this." With a final shuddering breath, Zorax's eyes dimmed, his life extinguished. Jason clutched the data crystal, a newfound resolve burning in his chest. He would not let Zorax's sacrifice be in vain. Leaving Vortis's motionless body behind, Jason and his team pushed onward, their determination fueled by grief and anger. They breached the central chamber, a cavernous space filled with pulsing organic matter interwoven with advanced technology. The Overmind loomed before them, a grotesque amalgamation of flesh and machine. Its voice boomed in their minds, dripping with disdain. "Foolish creatures, you stumble blindly into our web, never realizing that we have been pulling the strings all along." Jason gritted his teeth, fighting against the psychic onslaught. He activated the secret weapon, a device that emitted a pulsing energy field. The Overmind recoiled, its psychic hold weakening as it writhed in agony. Seizing the moment, Jason darted forward, planting explosive charges at critical junctures. He set the timer, the seconds ticking down as he and his team raced for the exit. The ground shook beneath their feet as the charges detonated, the stronghold collapsing in on itself. Jason barely made it out, diving clear as tons of rubble buried the Overmind and its twisted machinations. News of the Overmind's fall spread like wildfire, the Andromedan forces faltering without their psychic overlords. The Allied forces pressed their advantage, reclaiming lost territories and pushing the enemy back. But even as celebrations erupted across the galaxy, Jason couldn't shake the feeling that the Overmind's final words held a darker truth. What greater threat lurked in the shadows, waiting to strike when they least expected it? The acrid stench of burning metal and scorched flesh filled Jason's nostrils as he led the charge against the remaining Andromedan forces. The once pristine corridors of their strongholds now lay in ruins, littered with the twisted remains of their fallen soldiers. Jason's heart raced with a mixture of adrenaline and purpose, knowing that every step brought them closer to ending this war once and for all. "Commander Johnson, we've intercepted a transmission from a hidden Andromedan research facility," a voice crackled through his comms. "It's located deep within the Xanthus Nebula." Jason's brows furrowed. "What could they be hiding out there? Send me the coordinates. We're going in." As the Allied forces pushed deeper into the nebula, an eerie stillness settled over the region. The vibrant swirls of gas and dust seemed to hold a sinister secret. Upon breaching the facility's defenses, Jason and his team were greeted by a sight that sent chills down their spines. Rows of containment pods lined the walls, each housing a twisted abomination of flesh and metal. The Andromedans had been experimenting on their own kind, fusing them with a strange, pulsating substance that emitted an otherworldly glow. "By the stars, what is that?" whispered Lieutenant Zara, her voice trembling. Jason approached a console, his eyes scanning the data scrolling across the screen. "Dark matter," he breathed. "They've been trying to weaponize it." The implications sent a shudder through the team. The research notes painted a grim picture of the Andromedans' intentions, a doomsday device capable of annihilating entire star systems. "We can't let them finish this," Jason said, his voice steel. "We have to destroy the reactor core now." As they raced through the facility, alarms blared and Andromedan soldiers swarmed to stop them. The air crackled with the exchange of blaster fire, the stench of ozone mixing with the coppery tang of blood. "Go, go, go," Jason shouted, his pulse rifle spitting bolts of energy into the enemy ranks. "We're almost there." They burst into the reactor chamber, a cavernous space dominated by a pulsating sphere of dark matter. The ground shook beneath them as the unstable energy source strained against its containment field. But, standing directly in front of the reactor core, was an unexpected figure. "Vortis," Jason growled. "Thought we killed you." The once fearsome Andromedan leader was now a grotesque fusion of his former self and the dark matter weapon. His body pulsed with unnatural energy, metallic tendrils snaking from his flesh. "So you may have destroyed the Overmind, but you won't stop our ascension," Vortis rasped, his voice distorted by the cybernetic implants. "The dark matter will make us gods." Jason and his team unleashed a barrage of fire, but Vortis moved with inhuman speed. He lashed out with tendrils of dark energy, slamming soldiers against the walls like ragdolls. Jason watched in horror as friends who fought by his side fell, their bodies broken and lifeless. "Jason!" Zara cried out as a tendril pierced her chest. "Destroy the reactor!" With a roar of anguish, Jason charged towards the reactor core. Vortis turned to face him, a twisted grin on his face. They clashed in a fury of blades and dark energy, sparks flying as Jason's plasma sword met Vortis's cybernetic claws. But Jason could feel himself tiring, his strength waning with each blow. It was then he saw an opening, a hairline fracture in the reactor's containment field. With a final desperate cry, Jason plunged his sword into the fracture. The dark matter reactor shuddered, cracks spreading across its surface until it finally shattered in a blinding explosion of energy. Vortis howled as the dark matter that fueled him erupted from his body, consuming him in a maelstrom of unstable power. The facility shook violently as the reactor went critical. Jason staggered to his feet, his armor battered and scorched. He raced through the collapsing corridors, dodging falling debris and gouts of flame. The few remaining survivors of his team followed close behind, their faces grim with the weight of their losses. They barely made it to their shuttle before the research facility exploded in a brilliant flash of light, the shockwave rattling their ship as they fled the nebula. Jason slumped against the bulkhead, his chest heaving with exhaustion and grief. The Andromedan threat was gone, but the cost had been too high. In the aftermath of the war, the Galactic Council convened to honor the fallen and forge a path towards lasting peace. Jason stood before them, his once proud shoulders now heavy with the burden of leadership. "We have won a great victory," he said, his voice raw with emotion. "But let us never forget the price we paid, the sacrifices made by those who fought beside us. Let their memory be the foundation upon which we build a better future for all." As the council members nodded solemnly, Jason knew his own journey was far from over. The scars of war ran deep, and he needed time to heal, to find a way to honor his fallen comrades. With a heavy heart, he stepped down from his role as commander and embarked on a solitary path of reflection and atonement. The galaxy would remember the heroes who stood against the Andromedan menace, and Jason would ensure their sacrifice was not in vain. For now, he would walk alone, seeking the strength to build a brighter tomorrow for all those who called the stars their home. You have reached the end of the story. If you enjoyed this story and want to support us, please leave a like and subscribe to our channel, and for every comment that says 88, I will heart every single one of them. Thank you for your time.